Brilliant.
Bradley's here now. Bradley, it's unusual to have you on your own.
It is, yeah.
Are you enjoying being on your own?
It's nice. I miss the boys, obviously.
Yeah.
Like, last time we were here all together. But, yeah, it's nice.
Quick word on the boys, because last year you did your 10th year anniversary tour, didn't you?
Yeah.
Went round the... Wow, was that?
Yeah, it was good. It was really nice. You know what? Like, we got to go back out and do a world tour. Like, got to go out to Asia and parts of Europe that we haven't been in ages. But then also, like, a really good time to look back on the past 10 years.
Nice.
I think we hadn't stopped and been like, what have we...
Did you get to South America and mainland America?
No, we didn't, unfortunately.
So it's about, down to Asia. Are you popular down there?
Yeah, well, we've always been there. Like, we've always gone and we've done parts of Philippines and Japan, and they've always been really good to us, so we try and go back as often as we can.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, wonderful.
Why did you split up?
I'm changing this narrative. We're still best mates. I'm seeing two of the boys. We'll go to the pub after this.
Are you?
So Danny's going boxing, I'm going to the pub. So
right.
Different. But yeah, we're like best mates. We catch up all the time, and it's just like a solid...
So you're doing some solo stuff at the moment.
Yes.
So the Vamps on a little bit of a kind of holiday.
You could call it that, yeah, maybe a holiday, yeah, sounds nice. We are doing stuff this year, but it's just unreleased at the moment, so I've semi-let the cat out of the bag there, so sorry about that, boys.
Yeah.
But we've got stuff planned this year, and I've got an album coming next year, so it's just trying to, like,
juggle
run the two
all
together, yeah. But I've been enjoying it at the moment.
Yeah, and you're genuinely mates, aren't you?
Yeah. Yeah,
so,
we are.
Yeah, you're like, so tell us about your solo career then. So, or your solo work. How long have you been writing it for?
Ooh, about 2 years. 2 years. So we had a conversation a couple of years ago about we weren't ready to write a sixth album yet. And I'd started writing a couple of songs that didn't feel right to either pitch out to other artists or kind of put in the setting of the band. So I just kind of started, I got the kind of bug for it and started writing an album. And then, yeah, finished up now. Album's getting mixed and mastered, so I did the majority of it in New York last year. So, yeah, it's been a fun pro.
Different, how different is the process then from, you know, for 10 years of being with the band and you all being a democracy, sort of,
yeah,
to all of a sudden it's just you?
I think there's, like, huge benefits to... Like, writing in the band is a bit of, like, a mixing pot of everyone's influences because we come from such different musical backgrounds as well. And we come from different parts of the UK, so everyone's got different stuff that they're throwing in. And I think I've never sat down by myself and really thought about either what I want to say or how I want to say it and the sound of it all. So I've kind of went back to bands that I grew up on and, like, listened to a lot of, like... I used to grow up on a lot of, like, Nirvana and Queens of Stone Age and these bands that I hadn't, like, dived back into for a long time. So it's different in the sense I get to really think about what I personally...
So you've done a grunge album?
Essentially, yeah. I wanted to do an all-out grunge album. Manager was like, ugh, maybe write a song with a chorus.
All right, so we're going to play one of the tracks. This is Picasso. Do you want to tell us a bit about it before we listen to it?
Yeah, this is the second single off the album that's coming next year.
What's it about? Why is it called Picasso? Because that's intriguing, isn't it?
Intriguing. What do you think it's about? What does it say to you?
Cubism and...
blue period.
I wonder if it is his blue period.
Maybe feeling a little bit blue.
Yeah. I imagine it's a bit of a collage. That's what he likes to do. Geometric shapes. So
the foundation of it, so you look at it and you think, I'm not quite sure what this means, and then there's a hidden depth to it that goes beyond the surface.
It's actually... nothing. It's really good. It's essentially about someone who, like, dresses up heartbreak in a beautiful way, and, like, someone who maybe it's not the best situation, but it's like the audacity of, like, who do you think you are, Picasso, because you make it look so beautiful.
Oh, I like it.
So
his answer's far better than ours.
Yeah, his answer's good.
Our record would have been rubbish. Right, here you go. Let's have a look. That's a good video. I've not seen you for a while. You look brilliant, by the way, at the moment.
You stop.
I love it. I love the whole look. Did you? We talked to Danny earlier, and he was writing with people. Did you write with people on this album?
Yeah. So I had like one main collaborator, which was a producer out of New York called Boots.
And he's famous, right? He's the man.
Yeah, there he is, the man himself. And like we met on FaceTime.
Who did Boots work with? He worked with everyone, didn't he?
He did Beyonce's self-titled album, and he did a lot with Run the Jewels as well. So he's a beast.
Wow.
And we met on FaceTime, and I was here, and he was in New York, and we got on well. But then I committed to 3 weeks, having never met him before.
And
so it went really well.
Oh, good.
It was lovely. It was like we went for coffee on the first day. And then we just got to know each other, and he was just a lovely bloke and a fantastic producer. And I really think he, like, helped me out, because I was like, I don't know. I've never done this before. I've never written by myself. I've had the safety of three of my best mates around me. And I wanted to put myself in an uncomfortable
position. Do you think that so when you're writing again with the boys, do you think almost what you're learning as a solo performer will go back into what happens with the Vamps?
Potentially, yeah.
Yeah.
It's funny, I was thinking about that the other day, and I'm like, Con's been doing a side project, and then so's James. So I think everyone's getting to explore different sides of them. And I think once we do come back together, there's going to be this like nice bringing this new stuff that you've learned, and like see how it influences the Vamps as well.
So UK tour sold out, isn't it?
Yeah, most of it. There's one, Heaven, on the 21st of November. Is that right, Manish? There's a couple of tickets left for Heaven, but yeah, the rest of the tour.
How mad is that? Just boom.
Yeah, it's crazy.
How's that make you feel?
Mind blown, because I was so nervous before we put the shows on, because I was like, I've got no idea. And the fans just kind of, it's an absolute credit to the fans. They've been amazing.
Will you do any Vamp songs?
At some point, absolutely, yeah. Like, I love being
with
the band.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
And I think we'll come back. We just got to a point, me and Danny were speaking about it before, it's nice to change things up, and then it inspires you, and you do it for the right reasons, for the love of, like, we feel ready to do it rather than putting the pressure of,
pretty cool job, isn't it?
Oh, I feel very, very lucky, man. Yeah, just to kind of prance around.
There's 10 years of mix. I mean, like, you guys have been coming on the show since you started. And,
Yeah, 17. I think you were one of our first ever TVs that we did.
We basically made you, really, didn't we? Like, that's what you say, Bradley, isn't it?
Did you enjoy your experience back then? Did you come off the show buzzing?
Absolutely buzzing, yeah. I remember Con rode like a wooden, I think it was a jockey week, or you had like a jockey with a fake horse, and he got on there.
That was it.
And then we play that video.
Do you remember thinking, isn't that Tim Lovejoy got lovely thick hair?
Golden locks like that.
Thanks, Bradley. Your new single, Picasso. Don't laugh at that. I'm going through trauma with my hair. I'm not really. Picasso. It's called the single Picasso. Cubism, the lot. Out now.